Welcome to the Raduga venue in the hills above Krasnoyarsk in the heart of Siberia. Built especially for this winter Universiad, it boasts 10 kilometers of ski tracks. Today's action is the mixed sprint relay. 20 teams made up of one man and one woman will each complete 6 laps, and it remains unseasonably warm in Krasnoyarsk. Although temperatures at the moment are below zero, knowing how to prepare the skis is tricky because sunny areas, like in the stadium, are softer than the tracks in the forest. So preparation will be a key factor. The maps going into the map wall as they prepare for this sprint relay. The fastest winning time this afternoon is expected to be around 35 minutes, depending, of course, on the state of the tracks. Every individual would be hitting round about 8 minutes a lap here. Ski orienteer Markku Valkonen is in the studio with me, looking at those temperatures, -1. Colder in the forest, though, the tracks are going to be icier and therefore faster in the forest than we've had on any other day. But Markku, talk us through these initial legs for the women.
We're going to have forking in the beginning, getting towards the joint controls there. And then it's uphill in the beginning, then we go on the top of the hill towards our second TV control on the top of the ski bridge, and then descending to the arena. So the ladies are going to run these two forked legs on the first and the third leg.
So a massed start today with 6 legs, 19 mixed teams of 2 and an all-woman team from Austria making up the 20th pairing. The women will do legs 1, 3 and 5. The men will go 2, 4 and then the final leg. So that is the start list. It's a mass start, but Markku, there is nonetheless an order. It's not complete chaos.
There is a method to madness here. It will be very tight. We will see changes of lead during the race, and again team tactics should be to keep cool head in the beginning.
So they will be going second, Marina Vyatkina and Sergei Gorlinov of Russia. Just ahead of them, Ervin Andersen and Jürgen Backlid of Norway. They've been given their map, so we're 15 seconds away from the start of this mixed sprint relay here in Krasnoyarsk 2019. They are off, and this is going to be fast and furious. Don't blink or you'll miss these legs. Round about 7 to 8 minutes for a lap. The women going first. Now, this is the first time they've had a chance to look at the maps. So they are skiing as fast as possible, but they are also orienteering, trying to read the maps, trying to come up with the best tracks that suit them. Lots of different tactics going into this race, depending on how people have done in the earlier races here in Krasnoyarsk. Some wanting to go the shorter routes along the icier, narrower, more difficult tracks. Others choosing to stay on the wider, faster routes. But right now, we've got the Russians, the Czechs and the Swedes pushing out in front. So the forking comes together at the next control point, which means we'll be able to see who is out in front.
Yes, and it's been all uphill so far, so you start to see some differences in the physical shape already at this stage.
The laps that the men and the women are doing are very similar, and the biggest uphill task is the uphill they're doing now, the bit of track between the first and the second control points. So Marina Vyatkina leading the way for Russia.
Followed by Italy and Stefania Corradini.
Finns in third. It's close between Saarinen and Nenninen. And already they're beginning their descent into the stadium with the Swedes leading ahead of the Russians and the Italians. Isabel Saarinen, who in the sprint fell She got stuck in loose snow. She had what she considered to be a terrible race, and she said this race would be different. She was going to stay cool and calm and play it safe. And at the moment, that tactic is working. Although it's the Italian Corradini who has taken the lead in the stadium as they come over to the exchange point right now.
And it seems that Vyatkina, who had really good days earlier, is physically now a little bit softer.
And so the women hand over to the men in this relay with the Italians out in front. Then it is Sweden. Sixten Valheim taking over for the Swedes and Francesco Corradini for the Italians. They grab their maps. Here comes the Russian Sergei Gorlanov for his first leg. You see them studying, taking it steady, making sure that they've got a plan in their heads where they want to go. So no change on this first part of the lap. You could see them just take that moment, that downhill moment to catch their breath. As Kazakhstan put on a good show, Kamila Ibrayeva. Finland through in fourth.
And Stefania Corradini is really pushing now and trying to secure the medal for Italy, because she was 15 seconds faster than Maria Vyatkina and Liisa Nenonen from the stadium up to the control which we saw.
So the Italians fastest so far on this lap, as they try to close in on the Russians. And it looks like Corradini has taken the lead over the Norwegians. So Italy into second now. There was an overtake at the third checkpoint for Corradini. And there's confirmation. We can see it in the pictures. The 17 of Corradini through the checkpoint ahead of Evin Andersen of Norway.
And for Italy, it's vital that Corradini gets some distance from Norway when they come to the exchange. And Finland, too, isn't that far away.
Athletes coming from different directions, because obviously they can choose the tracks to follow. They can choose which they think is the shortest, the quickest track. As Vyatkina enters the stadium, and another cheer drives her on as she pushes every ounce of stamina out of her lungs, through her legs. And barring disaster, you've got to say the gold is already in the Russians' pockets. No sign in the stadium yet of the chasing pack. As she rounds this bend for the final time, she will hand over to her partner Sergei Gorlanov, who will complete the race in his final lap. So here's Corradini. Gorlanov's away. Right, we're still on the far side of the stadium, on the straight. Corradini trying to get away from the Norwegian, trying to give her brother as many seconds advantage as she can. And standing beside Francesco Corradini is Jürgen Backlid of Norway. Encouraging her brother. Now, it'll be interesting to see how long he takes over orientating himself, reading the map again this time.
Thank you.
The Finns, Evert Toivonen, still chasing a medal. Evert choosing not to wear sunshades like these two. Instead, the Finn marking his cheekbones with that black paint to stop the glare of the sun on the snow. And this is how they stand then, as we go into the final lap.
Italy is missing from these results, but we saw Italy there coming in as the second.
So we can ignore that.
We can probably ignore that for the time being and focus on the battle.
They're just trying to confuse us. Sergei Gorlanov of Russia goes uphill for the final time. This long, hard uphill leg to the first checkpoints, followed by the Italian. And Gorlanov said that, you know, yes, he'd worked really hard in the sprint and the pursuit earlier in the week, but they had a day off yesterday, well, a day off from competing anyway, and he felt that his tiredness had gone. He was feeling good.
And now we see that Norway and Jørgen Barklid has made a mistake. And Italy, Francesco Corradini took the right route choice there. And also Finland will be passing Norway towards the fight for the bronze. So a bad mistake by Jørgen Barklid.
A mistake by Norway. They've gone the long way round and Italy have extended their lead and Norway have been overtaken by Finland as well. So Jørgen Barklid getting it wrong at that intersection and dropping back down into fourth place.
Russia in comfortable lead, taking a safe route choice there towards the second control and avoiding climbing there. And if nothing special happens there, then Russia will definitely take the gold, but the other medals are, the race is completely open.
You can see how close it is in that bronze medal position as they try and hunt down Italy in second.
And Corradini again making the right route choice from the right, and then apparently the other teams, two Norwegian teams in Finland, are just following him. Now they go really fast downhill towards the second control, and then there is a climb, the final climb for men in this race, race towards the TV control, the third control. And the teams are catching Italy.
We will see our leader emerge shortly. There he is.
And he won't be needing to use his tricks.
It's all about just getting to the finish line now for Sergei Gorlanov. His advantage is clear. Now, this is where Norway got it wrong.
It's still Gorlanov.
This is Gorlanov. So we're waiting for the second place.
And here we see where Norway got it wrong. And they lost about 15 seconds by making the route choice, which was much lower. And we are now awaiting anxiously the teams to arrive to our TV control to see how closely together the teams are.
So Marina Vyatkina waiting for her teammate to come into the stadium.
And it is Norway first team who has corrected their mistake.
So a mistake from Norway earlier on, but they've rectified it. Jørgen Barklid has come back and has overtaken the Italians. So Corradini has dropped down into third.
and different route choices towards the last controls, and this will be very, very interesting. Barclay taking his own route and the other teams taking choosing another route, whereas we see Gorlanov now reaching towards the finish.
With Gorlanov as he begins his descent into the stadium. And you can see the battle for silver and bronze unfolding behind him. There are at least four athletes at the moment battling for two medals.
And we will definitely see different route choices there, because if you are 15 meters fast behind and you know you can't beat the guy in skiing, you take different route choice.
Sergei Gorlanov is in the stadium. He is skiing in front of the home fans. He is skiing towards the finish line. Sergei Gorlanov and Marina Vyatkina, already four medals in their pockets from the week. And now he turns for the final time and makes his way along the home straight towards the finish line. It has been a dominant performance from this Russian pair. The young Marina Vyatkina holding her own, and Sergei Gorlanov showing why he is one of Russia's top ski orienteers. And Gorlanov and Vyatkina celebrate Russia's fourth gold in ski orienteering. So the battle for silver and bronze is between the two Norwegians. Audun Heimdal, wearing the number four, trying to catch Jürgen Backlid. And we've seen sprints this week between teammates. Who is going to come off this time? At the moment, it looks like Backlid has the advantage going to the home straight. They'll pick their lanes as they come round the bend. And it's Jürgen Backlid of Norway out in front. Jürgen Backlid and Evin Andersen have taken silver in the mixed sprint relay for Norway. And right behind him, just a matter of seconds, Audun Heimdal crosses the line. He and Tilla Henum will take the bronze. Also crossing the line now from Finland, Evert Toivonen, just out of the medals. So it was a real sprint to the finish line for silver and bronze by the two Norwegian teams. And in the end, just 2 seconds separated silver from bronze. But a dominant performance from the Russians, winning by over a minute. Disappointment for Italy, though. In that final lap, they were in line for a medal, but in the end, they had to settle for fifth. And Finland's second team coming in fourth. We'll be right back.
We're glad to greet you at the awarding ceremony for the 29th Winter Universiade Krasnoyarsk 2019 for ski orienteering mixed team sprint. Third place and bronze medalists, Team of Norway. Составе команды represented by Tila Farnes Hennum и Audun Heimdall.
And what a battle it was for silver and bronze in this race, but Audun Heimdall just couldn't quite reel in his Norwegian teammate. So it is bronze for him and Tila Hennum.
Thank you.
Second place and silver medalists, Team of Norway. Составе команды represented by Evan Wesley Andersen and Jørgen Baklid.
A great final sprint to the line from Jørgen Baklid. But a great performance all round for Evine Andersen as well. And this is Norway's third ski orienteering medal. Two of them won on this podium.
Okay, congratulations.
Thank you.
The winners of the 29th Winter Universiade Krasnoyarsk 2019, Team of Russian Federation, Sastavi Komande, represented by Marina Vyatkina и Сергей Карланов.
Russia's fourth gold and seventh medal overall in ski orienteering. This pair have won five of the seven medals. So a dominant performance all round from Marina Vyatkina, the 19-year-old from, well, just down the road, the Siberian Federal University. And a great performance from Sergei Gorlanov.
I have one more, please.
It's been a thrilling day of racing in the mixed sprint relay. Hope you enjoyed it. From me, Alec Wilkinson, it's goodbye for now.